I have to welcome Dr. Michael Mosley to our country. Or should I even say that? Because you belong to India, I feel.
Yes,
you were born
here.
हाँ, वो यहाँ पे पैदा हुए कलकत्ता में और परवरिश उनकी अब्रॉड हुई है. But I feel very happy that he believes in Indian food and the power that Indian foods have, and he propagates that with whatever little I've read about him, seen of him. I love the fact that there is someone out there in the West who is propagating Indian foods, and I welcome that. So welcome to India.
Thank you. Back again.
Yes. And also have to take the opportunity to congratulate Sony BBC Earth on completing a year and being the number one channel.
Wow.
So yes, I really believe that most people underestimate the power of food, and a lot of people think that hitting the gym is enough. And I've always said this, and I'm going to repeat myself, that it is 70% diet and 30% some kind of workout regime, whether it is yoga, cardio. And I think it's pretty much the same thing that even Dr. Mosley also says. So I'm going to leave it to you now.
Sure.
Because he is the doctor. And, I think he speaks beautifully, and what he says makes a lot of sense, and it stayed with me.
Thank you.
And he's also the man behind the intermittent diet. I don't know if you've heard of it, but I have. I've followed it. I've never done it, but I do want to do it. I really believe that the benefits are huge. Mm. The whole 5:2 kind of diet plan is wonderful, where you eat for 5 days and 2 days in between you fast, which is pretty much a philosophy of Ayurveda. Correct me if I'm wrong.
No, absolutely right.
Yes. So it again comes from the whole Indian ethos of eating. Please tell us more about that.
Thank you. Yes, so I mean, what is fantastic is coming back to India after all these years having been born here. And it's not just the sort of Indian foods that I embrace, but also many of the Indian practices, which have now, scientists have become very interested in fasting, intermittent fasting, also mindfulness, meditation, and I believe you teach yoga. And I'm going to ask her to show me some yoga poses soon. But any other fans of yoga here? We now know that yoga is, again, incredibly good form of exercise, but also good for the mind as well as the body. So I think that, if you like, modern science is slowly catching up with things that have been known here in India for a couple of thousand years. The only thing I would say, which is kind of bad at the moment, is that you guys are heading towards type 2 diabetes at a very fast rate, and I think it's important to find ways to correct that, because one of the myths which is out there is that doctors have all the answers, and I'm afraid they don't. That a lot of your fate is in your own hands. And it's about discovering the foods and the lifestyle and the things which will restore you to balance. And that's really kind of what the programs I make are all about. And one of the things I always do is I do the experiments on myself. So the reason I got interested in nutrition is because 6 years ago, I discovered that I was a type 2 diabetic, like my father. And I suspect like a lot of your fathers and mothers in this room. Because almost everyone I've spoken to in India so far has a parent who's got type 2 diabetes. And the doctors will tell you that it is an irreversible disease and you have to keep on taking the medicines. And I can promise you that is not true. It is possible to reverse. I did the 5-2 diet. I lost 10 kilos. My blood sugars returned to normal, where they have stayed ever since. So as far as I'm concerned, I'm cured. And that is a message I want to take out.
That's wonderful, Doc. That's very, very inspiring. And the fact that you are just not preaching, you are actually practicing what you preach, which I really think is essential. Because बहुत लोग होते हैं कि कहते हैं कि ये आपको करना चाहिए, ये करना चाहिए, लेकिन आप अपनी ज़िंदगी कैसे जी रहे हैं? I think सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है कि आप एक अगर आप हेल्थ पूरी तरीके से एंजॉय करना चाहते हैं, मैं लाइफ नहीं बोल रही हूँ, मैं हेल्थ enjoy karna chahte hai ka istemal kar rahi hu because hum health ko kya hai bahut ek apathy sa hai health ko leke ki jab tak kuch ho nahi jata hum log health ko seriously nahi lete hai. What I'm saying to them is that we don't take health seriously till we are diagnosed with an ailment.
Indeed.
And bahut hi unfortunate baat hai kyunki life is given to us for free, which is why I feel most people, you know, don't know the value of it. तो ये जो apathy है health को लेके और जो diabetics हैं, अगर वो समझे कि वो reversible है और हो सकता है, अगर आप सालों से diabetic हैं और बहुत ही highly diabetic हैं, तो obviously आपको डॉक्टरों का ज़्यादा मानना चाहिए. But if you've just been diagnosed with diabetes and you know you are obese, you can reverse it.
Yes. So even if you're not obese, some people.
Yeah.
I wasn't. I'm exactly. What's called a toffee, thin on the outside, fat inside. Lots of fat in there, which is, I'm afraid, a lot of particularly Indian men, when they put on the fat, they put it on around the tummy, and that's the worst sort.
So I think most importantly, I think what you're trying to focus on is when you said mindful eating. I think most people don't do mindful eating. We just eat
whatever
comes to our mind. You just eat that. So mindful eating is one of the first to-dos on the list if you want to enjoy better health. And for me, I really feel it's also a lifestyle modification that I have made in my life.
Yes.
Doc, you know, you are someone who is the trained nutritionist. You you have your degree. I unfortunately haven't done all of that, but I believe that, you know, I have experimented on myself, and I feel very proud about the fact that I feel healthier, I feel more alive today than I was even 12 years ago.
Indeed, feel alive.
Feeling alive, really. And I have seen the difference that food has made to me, the timings have made to me. So it is a lifestyle modification that I have made in my life, which I'm trying to propagate, and you are doing the same.
Absolutely.
With people.
So, Shilpa and Doc, can you talk about some of the
Indeed, some of the foods. So, let's have a look. Eggs. Who thinks eggs are good for you? Who thinks they're bad for you? So, for a long time, doctors have been telling us to cut down the eggs because they have cholesterol, but now we know that eggs are really good for you. I have a couple of eggs most mornings for breakfast, and I find it fills me up.
Yes.
So, there we go. Eggs are brilliant.
You talk about the yellow in the egg, that, you know, most people think that the yellow isn't very good. Even if you're not, if you don't have cholesterol, they take out the yellow for some reason. I just feel that just kills the whole taste and the properties in an egg, you know.
It's crazy because basically that is where all the goodness is.
Exactly.
Because it's there to feed the chick.
Exactly.
You know?
Explain that to people.
Bonkersness. The other one is, let's see what we got. We've got some nuts here. You're fond of nuts?
I love nuts. I am nuts.
These are walnuts, but
I love them.
Again, people think, you know, nuts perhaps are bad for you because they have lots of fat in them, but walnuts are fabulous, aren't they?
I think it's the best snack that you can carry.
Yeah.
It's non-perishable for a really long time. In India, we have ants, so you have to make sure that it's like completely covered.
Now, I am guessing this is ghee?
No, I think it is.
Was it butter?
Let me smell it.
You going to have a sniff?
You think? It's ghee.
Okay. What do you think about ghee?
I love clarified butter. And in India, you get a better version, which is white butter, before you make it into ghee. So it's got butyric acid, which is great. It works like, you know, it prepares your gut to digest food. I love it. It's in all my food. I have at least a teaspoon and a half or 2 teaspoons of ghee every day on my brown rice.
Okay, brown rice, yeah.
Yeah. Doc doesn't like rice.
No, I like brown rice.
He likes brown rice.
Too much white rice.
Yeah.
White rice is kind of like eating sugar.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, that's one of the bad things in the Indian diet.
Yes.
Too much white rice.
Yeah. No, true. But really, Doc, tell me, how much is the difference between, I think it would only be the fiber, or is there that much sugar even in brown rice?
There is some, but it isn't so rapidly absorbed.
So the
white rice is like sort of consuming sugar, and we kind of know that sugar is not terribly good for you.
It's terrible.
White rice also has quite a lot of arsenic in it, so which is not terribly good. So you're much better off with lentils and with things like that. If you can cut down or shift to brown rice. I have children, and what we did is they didn't like brown rice, so we just put more and more brown in it until eventually they kind of got used to it.
Wonderful. You know, you're talking of lentils. I really love sprouted lentils.
Yeah.
I feel otherwise it tends to make you a little gaseous.
Indeed.
But in India, we use something called asafoetida,
okay,
which is like a permanent fixture in all our kitchens for our lentils. Hing, hum hing ka bahut zyada istemal karte hain. Bachcho ko agar stomach upset hota hai, so we actually use ghee and we put a bit of asafoetida
right
into the navel of the child, and it actually relieves them of flatulence.
Okay.
So we do stuff like this in India, and it's been done for time immemorial, and even the West has started understanding the uses and the properties of spices like asafoetida, turmeric.
Turmeric is huge. No, we did an experiment on, trust me, because there's been a lot of interest. You cook a lot with turmeric, don't you? Do you call it turmeric or turmeric?
We call it haldi, but it's called turmeric.
Different name.
Yeah.
But it has become incredibly fashionable in the UK and in Sydney and America. Turmeric latte.
Yes.
You know, very popular.
Can you believe it?
But what people have wondered is it really as good as people say? So we did a study on Trust Me, I'm a Doctor, where we got lots of people who don't normally eat it to eat it. And they put in their cooking, these were people who don't normally eat Indian food at all. And we also looked at the same time at their DNA. Mm-hmm. We did a special test. And what we found is there were improvements in about 3 months in some of the genes linked with things like cancer and inflammation.
Yes.
And this is the first proper scientific study done looking at the benefits of turmeric.
Yes.
And that was fabulous.
Yes. I think curcumin, which is a derivative of turmeric, is used widely to rehabilitate cancer patients as well.
Indeed. They're doing some of the early studies in it now. It's interesting because all these sort of foods have been around for a long time.
Exactly.
Only more recently are people actually doing proper scientific studies. And the other one is coconut oil. We fans of coconut oil here? So I did a big experiment with Cambridge University, which is one of the best universities in the world. And the professor was convinced that the coconut oil would be really bad because it's a saturated fat, it would raise their cholesterol levels. So we did the experiment with over 100 people. And she was really, really surprised because it turned out that actually the people taking the coconut oil, they saw improvements in their cholesterol and also in inflammation. And this was the exact opposite of what she was expecting.
Yes.
But they published it in a big scientific journal.
Yeah.
And that's what I love about doing programs like Trust Me, I'm a Doctor.
Yeah.
Is
I saw that episode. I have to say, I love the fact that you divided them into three groups and you saw the relevant difference between even the olive oil and the coconut oil, literally nearly 10%.
Absolutely.
So it brought down cholesterol levels to literally 5% with people who had olive oil, and with coconut oil it came down by nearly 15%. Well done, yeah. Look at that. So, I mean, it's terrible sometimes as an Indian for me to sit back and see that people are cooking their foods in all kinds of oils, and we are scared to use what we actually call superfoods in the West.
Yes.
You know? So I was actually at another event, and I brought it to everyone's notice that when I went to Holland and Barrett, coconut oil and clarified butter, which is ghee,
indeed,
is put on the top shelves, and we are cooking, I mean, with due respect to olive oil, which I feel has a very low heating point, we're cooking Indian food in those oils and, you know, all the other kinds of oils
indeed
that we have. So I really wish people went back to the roots, and I really feel that even right up to, like, you know, 70 years ago, Indians led far healthier lives than the lives we're leading today.
I'm afraid so.
What do you have to say? There was this other myth that I heard about, because it's full of B vitamins and,
yep,
you know, it's very, they say it's very, very nutritious, but this whole myth about being diabetic.
Yeah.
And they said that if you could actually go on to a fruit diet,
okay,
and if you ate loads of fruit, you could actually cure yourself of even diabetes.
Okay.
So that's another myth. You have to that do another thing on that.
Oh, absolutely. That is a total myth, unfortunately. Fruit juice is much worse than fruit because it has no fiber in it and it's very bad for your sugar levels. And eating a load of fruit is very, very bad for diabetics. Because it just, it's a load of fructose in it, which gets turned to fat.
But that is the myth. I don't even know what to believe anymore because, you know, I read a piece on it. I also saw an entire documentary on it where they actually said that doctors would tell you that don't eat fruit. But if you actually began to eat more portions of fruit, the right kind of fruits, you would actually be able to reverse diabetes. So I don't know how much of the
I think it's wildly, there's so many
researchers out there. One minute they say that, you know, dairy is bad for you, the next minute they'll say, oh, milk is what is the best thing that's happened to human beings. Then they say
why you have to watch Trust Me I'm a Doctor, because you have to trust us, you know.
You have to trust
us
because he's a doctor.
Honestly.
A lot of people feel that either you should follow only protein diets or not eat carbohydrates at all. Now some people say you should turn vegan, not consume dairy products at all because dairy products add to a lot of weight. So according to you, because you, I think, are one of fitness person who we have seen and you look young as ever. So
without
what
Botox.
What do you have to say on this?
Well, I just have one line to say. Just keep it simple. I just think that, you know, unfortunately, carbs have been vulgarized, and I love my carbs. Carbs is what gives you fuel. But choose the right carbs, you know.
Lentils.
Exactly. Lentils, vegetables, root vegetables. I love potatoes. Even potatoes. People run away from potatoes. Don't have them fried. Have them boiled. They're actually great for your body because they're alkaline foods, and beetroots. I love carbs. I have sourdough bread in the morning. I stay away from stuff that is mass produced. I like stuff that is made in small kitchens, made from scratch. I do, but I have bhais ka doodh, which has more iron, more than cow's milk. Shoot me. I'm trying to reduce even on that. there are so many myths. The one thing that I've really changed in my life over the last 3 weeks recently is cutting down on sugar, which has been a huge modification, and Dr. will elucidate
on
that.
No, I love sugar. I try to cut it down. Yeah, it's incredibly addictive.
It is addictive. And they say sugar has the same effect as cocaine. You just get addicted to it. And it is so scary that...
I was on Elephant Island yesterday, and the monkeys there are obviously addicted to sugar because they're just grabbing the ice creams from all the tourists.
Yeah.
And I have a photograph of a monkey with two ice creams in his face. And I was just thinking, poor bloody monkeys, they're going to get diabetes and lose their teeth.
Exactly.
And so they just love it. And we know that if you offer animal sugar, rats, monkeys, they will eat huge amounts of it. And the same is true of humans.
Exactly. So that is the one thing that you need to start reducing and becoming aware of, because it is poison. And so much so that I've actually taken out sugar from my son's life.
I bet he complained.
No, you know what, Doc? It's what you teach your child.
I know.
So it's pretty difficult in a time and age where every mall, every place that you go to buy something, the counter has lollipops, gummy bears, wine gums, and it's very, very tempting for a little child because he doesn't know the difference between right and wrong. But you have to tell him and explain to him that, you know, this is going to make you hyperactive. They say that a spoon of sugar brings down your immunity for the next 6 hours. So imagine what that does to your body.